Hi, welcome back, everybody. I'm Magic Runes. And having fun painting today. Just want to remind everybody that December 4th, Saturday at 5 o'clock, in the TC War Room at TC Paintball in Traverse City, we're going to have a painting event. $20 will get you a model, paints, and two brushes. And we're going to spend roughly 2 hours painting the model, having fun, and just genuinely enjoying each other's company during the holidays. I hope you can make it. Alright, let's get started. I have a few spots I missed with the airbrush. And I want to dive right in and clean those spots up real quick. And I forgot. I didn't even airbrush his helmet. I missed the inside of this weapon. And I missed his toes. We're gonna need purple. We're gonna need Cantor blue. The purple is Phoenician. Phoenician purple. Cantor blue. And then our red is the always magnificent, oh, don't break stuff, Mephiston red. Okay. Need a little hairbrush juice. Get in here, see what I'm doing, roughly. A little airbrush, medium, flow improver. You can get this stuff at your local hobby shop. Mine is the TC War Room at TC Paintball in Traverse City. And most of the time, I thin down the paints somewhere between 30 and 50%. The actual airbrush paints themselves don't need to be thinned as much. I'm just going to get a couple drops in here. Make sure you got your paper towels handy. Painting is messy work, and it should be. I also like to use a crappy brush. Once you've got the mixture in the paint, kind of see how much I got in there. It's not much. I usually use my brush to kind of stir that up. Now you don't want to push super hard or break off any bristles in there, because that can just cause you problems with clogging and stuff, but just a gentle little stir. A little Bob Ross happy stir. Get a little paper towel, make sure we got a good flow. Oh yeah. Flowtastic. Well, let's see if I get an angle that you guys can see this. So at home, I have a full-size compressor with a massive tank. And an even more massive and ridiculously loud compressor. It doesn't take long for it to fill, but it'll spray forever without that thing going off at all. I leave my little compressor up at the TC War Room at TC Paintball. Because when I'm there, that one's quiet. I can use it in the shop, and it's just a lot easier to deal with. Yeah, we got a little purple on there. And as you can see, realized, obviously, later that I'm missing a knee there. We're going to have to do that. The other part, or this knee, is at TC Paintball, so I have to get it, paint it, and then we can just paint it separately, and I'll toss it on there. Wouldn't be a big deal. I wanted a little more purple in the middle of this. And we are going to get a little red in that shadow up towards these top edges. Just want to put the purple on there first. Get it looking good. Nice, magnificent fade. And we're going to touch up any areas that just kind of didn't quite get the love that they needed. Feet. Seriously can't believe I forgot the feet last time. And the purple's going into the shady areas. Which will kind of be the sides. Happy. Now we're going to need to switch out for some blue. Let me just get the airbrush clean. I'll be right back. Doing most of my airbrush work in the kitchen so that I can be right next to the sink. For switching out colors on the airbrush, it just makes it so nice. They have a sink right next to you. Be able to switch these colors out. Okay. Now we're going to want some Cantor blue. What first we're going to do is get a little bit of airbrush love. This Cantor blue is thick, so we're going to need extra liquidy love. I need more Cantor Blue. We got plenty to get this done, though. That should get us done. And that's going to be a little watery. Well, you know what? Can work with a little watery. Oh yeah, that's a nice smooth flow. Gotta have good light for this. I can't stress that enough. If you don't have good light, you're not gonna be able to make the super buttery fades, because you'll end up putting too much and creating a hard separation. Well, and sometimes that'll just happen because you go straight noob on the airbrush and just yank the paddle back too hard. Yeah, that makes me happy. Okay. You guys feeling good about that? I feel pretty good about that. I feel like we got every spot we missed. Okay, feet. sure about that. Clean up the airbrush and we'll bring in a little more red. Medium. Not a lot though, because this Mephiston Red is the air bottle. Most of you are probably aware of that. You can buy your pots of Games Workshop paint, but you can buy double sized pots that actually have the paints pre thinned for airbrush painting. But, that being said, I still thin them even more. Thin and runny can be a real pain in the butt. But chunky clogged up airbrushes are 10 times the amount of the pain in the butt. Plasma rifle red a little bit. And then we're just going to throw some little shots on his feet. Oops. A little too aggressive there. Not too crazy. Okay. Happy feet. Let's rinse out the airbrush and then we can do some metal painting. What I like to do after that is take a little bit of alcohol. If I'm going to let the airbrush sit for a little while, a few drops of alcohol in the bucket or in the pot that's built onto your airbrush. Just kind of make sure that nothing like hardens up in there or gets nasty. Okay. Good. Who's ready for lead belcher? On a model like this, you just end up using lead belcher for days. Lead belcher. And lead belcher we put on with a brush. These metallic paints, oh my goodness. All of that airbrushing, and I did it again. I forgot to. We're gonna paint the helmet completely separately, just for fun, and because I forgot. I hear lots of horror stories, of people clogging up their machines using those metallic paints and just causing issues and stuff. So for the most part, I try to avoid it. I mean, it's thinning them out too. I wonder if you'd have to put, like, even with the airbrush, like 5 or 6 coats to finally get it to look like, you know, that metallic-y real sheen or whatever. Been a minute. I want to clean up this lead belcher brush. I use this stuff, the Master's brush cleaner. You can get that at your local hobby shop. I'm not sure if John and Mike carry this at TC Paintball, but as far as brush cleaners go, this has proven to be my favorite. Man, it gets the job done. And if you clean your brush before you put it away, and you're like, feather out that super fine, perfect tip, well, then it'll just dry that way with this perfect tip and then stay awesome forever. Forever, ever? Yes. Forever. Oh no. Oh. That spill could have gone a lot worse. I'm almost out of this anyways. So many paints to buy. And that lid cracked. I'm gonna have to grab another one. I used to move my paints into dropper bottles and then got away from it for a number of issues. One, the clog like crazy. Two, these caps end up splitting. Just more stuff we can't have to do anything else. I got a giant bag of these. Still left over. So the ones that I have left, I just kind of limp along. But I kind of figured out how to use the pots a little better as far as getting the paint out. And now that, you know, after watching videos and learning from everybody else, but yeah, that's a video for another time. Right now I must paint. Got our lead belcher. Have our water. I keep the water over here away from my laptop. So even the metallic paints, I still bring some water in and I slim them down a bit. It's Duncan that does the two thin coats, and by golly, he's right. Two of them. On everything. I can't see. I need my goggles on. There we are. Let's get in here and have some fun. Sorry, some of these angles I have to get doesn't make it easy for me to put you guys in the picture here. Gently, gently. Now this is a this is an eBay bought model that we're basically rescuing. Yeah, it was in bad shape when we got it. Some people get ambitious about, you know, building something awesome. They get a model and they either haven't built one before or they're rushing to throw it together. And, you know, they don't clean up the little bits and, you know, they're not worried about it being a piece of art. They just want to put the toy together and go play the game. And honestly, I can't blame them. Everybody has their different ways they like to enjoy Warhammer. More miniature gaming. But I like them to look pretty. Still got a little bit of gold there we can deal with, or will I have to get more out? No, I think we've got some we can work with here. There. Let's see if we can make this work. Thank you. Totally metallic metal. Totally metal. Magnificent. Okay, now I know that we're gonna do bronze. You know what? We're gonna do a Balthazar gold. Because I'm feeling it. Looks kind of coppery. And mainly because I like it. And I want to have some fun right now. Get in there and get a big chunk of this totally metal. Paint for the paint gods. We'll dip in the water. We'll dip in the Balthazar gold. I got it a little wet. Just slightly wetter than I wanted it to be. But that's okay. I'm gonna work with it. I'm just gonna try to avoid filling up those holes with that color. And we're definitely coming in with a second coat of this bad boy. But we're also painting this. But we're not going to go all the way up. Because there's soot coming out of that chugga chugga stack. Exhaust. Whatever the hell you want to call it. And we want to make it look like it's definitely dirty towards the top. Towards the back side, there's a little bit of red overspray. You know, in the future, I may try that. Put this copper over some red spray on black. That is a cool effect. Can we do it again? We can sure try. Thank you. got some plasma weapon ideas. First things first. Gotta clean this baby up. Thanks for hanging out, everybody. Had fun today. I'm going to continue to work, but going to shut the stream down for now and grab some lunch. All right, have a wonderful day, and a happy Thanksgiving if I don't see you.